People love their parallax. That's when you're scrolling down a page and the image moves at a different speed than what you're scrolling. And people love this feature. Now, Elementor, which is an amazing page builder, for some reason, they have not added this true parallax scrolling feature to it. But the good news is there are three different ways that you can add parallax to your Elementor pages that you're building. And we're going to cover them in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. And if you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell off to the right. Anything I talk about in this video, I'll put a link to down below. And you might want to definitely reference that because there's going to be three different things we're talking about in this video. So we've got these three ways of getting parallax. Let's go ahead and jump into the three ways and then let's test it a little bit and see what the different results are with these different ways of doing it. Well, actually, the first way of getting parallax scrolling, I'm not going to actually demonstrate in this video. This is the original, the OG way of adding parallax to your website. It's just an article here on Sniffle Valve. This is Lyle Chamey, who has this amazing blog where he's made some really, really in-depth tutorials on features like this that you can add to Elementor. I'll put a link to this blog post down below. Now, this is a method that's going to involve adding some custom code to your website. It's really not that hard to do. In fact, he even has a video of his own down here on how to do it. So essentially, we're just adding this little snippet of code right here and this little snippet of code right here. And he's going to show you how to get the parallax scrolling. And I could say from, I watched his video when he first released it, this is an excellent way. There's no cost to it to getting parallax scrolling on your Elementor page. And this is actually the way I'm not going to test in this video. You can watch how he does it in his video. But what's nice about this is you have some control over the speed of the parallax. So that's how fast that scrolling happens as you're scrolling, which is one of the really nice things about this method. That this actually might be the best method, doesn't cost any money, and it's easy to implement. So that's Lyle's blog. I'll put a link to this down below. The next is something new. There's a plugin that just came out called Granular Controls for Elementor, and this is a free plugin. It adds a lot of neat things to this Elementor, kind of the way you interact with Elementor. Doesn't add anything really new to it, but does add this parallax feature. So we're going to test that out. But this is a really neat plugin. It just came out. I'm usually very hesitant on recommending any of these plugins for Elementor because I don't know if the developer is really going to be committed to it and is going to make sure that it works as Elementor is moving fast, that they're going to update their plugin to make it move just as fast and quickly respond to changes that Elementor makes. So here's one of them, and we're going to test this one out in the video. And the last option is a paid option. Now, if there was any Elementor add-on plugin today that I think is a good buy, it would definitely be Elementor Extras. They have all these neat things that they're adding, design features to Elementor, and one of them is parallax, and it's right here, so you can see it as I'm scrolling. You see how the content of the section is moving at a different pace of that image back there. That's one of the features it adds is the parallax, and there are some features that it gives you to control the amount of parallax and some of those controls that you get out of Lyle's article. Just a quick note, the reason I would recommend their add-on plugin over all the other ones is they're the only add-on plugin that's not trying to make an Elementor Pro clone, and that's what I like about it. Elementor is in this lane, and Elementor Extra stays out of Elementor's lane. It's not trying to copy and provide an alternative to Elementor Pro. In fact, they are trying to make Elementor Pro shine even more with the different modules that they add right here. I'll put a link. You can check this out or just do a Google search for Elementor Extras. Here's the cost of it. Now, this is not a free solution. It does give you more control, and we're going to test it. But right here, you can see for a single site, It's 26 euro. So I don't know what that would end up being in US dollars. I think maybe like 30 US dollars. So it's not an expensive plugin. And so anyways, let's go ahead and test these out. So I've gone ahead and installed and activated that add-on, that free plugin called Granular Controls for Elementor. Now, I think I'll do maybe a video off of some of its different features, but the settings for this are going to be found in under Elementor, and then it adds this new option called Granular Controls. Now, this is something that will not be activated by default. You would have to go into the settings and turn on the Parallax feature. So here are the various things it does. Let me just do a quick snapshot. It's really, I think, overcoming some of the annoyances people might have, or they might have different preferences for some of the things that Elementor does. So here's an option to keep accordions closed, remove the Elementor dashboard widget. Editor options, this is going to be the one we're looking at. There's options to change the color and change how many elements are in a row, stuff like that. But here it is, enable parallax. So you'll want to click on yes right here. And they also have the ability to enable particles. That's where you have these like little things floating around if that interests you. And you can also tweak some of the additional behavior in Elementor. Here's another one I'll probably do a video on later. And that's right here where you can add a custom welcome panel to your WordPress dashboard that you've designed in Elementor. That's pretty neat. If you're making Elementor based websites for clients, you'll be able to use this free plugin and have some kind of dashboard welcome that has the content that you would want in it, maybe pointing to where to get support from you and things of that nature. So that is this plugin, but we're really just going to hit this editor thing. So let's go ahead and take a look at the parallax settings and effect on this, and then we're going to try it with Elementor extras. So I already have some templates in my library, my Elementor library. This is a throwaway WordPress website, so it's okay if I break it. Here it is, parallax. And so I'm going to go ahead and click on edit with Elementor, open this sucker up in a new tab, and here it is. So the parallax can only be applied to Elementor sections. It can't be applied to maybe an image here or some random thing. It's only sections. So the option is going to be found in the sections panel. So here we are right here. I'm going to click right here to get the section options. I'm going to click on style. And when you scroll down, there will be this new option right here that says enable parallax. And you can just turn it on. Now, when you turn it on, it doesn't give you additional controls. And in my testing of this, the parallax isn't strong enough to really notice it. So let me show you with it off. It's just normal. I'm scrolling, right? Now, here is with it on. I'm going to turn it on. And it's kind of hard to notice. You might notice a little bit right here. You see, it's kind of really hard to notice. I even put an image down here to try to notice it more. Let's see if I have it turned on in this section. Let's see, I'm going to scroll down. My parallax is on. It's just so subtle in my testing that it's really hard to notice. So unfortunately, this way of getting parallax, I find, is too subtle for it to be really useful at this point. Now, that doesn't mean that the developer won't add maybe an additional control to give you the ability to control it, or at least have some kind of setting to increase the parallax effect so it's actually noticeable, but it's just not noticeable here. Here, let me show you a preview of the page. So this is going to open it up in a new tab, and we can look at it again, and you're going to see it's still kind of hard. So I have it on this section right here. You can see you're not getting it the normal way. You see that? You can kind of see it right here. As I scroll, you're going to see some of this effect start to appear. So it's very subtle and hard to notice. And so the same thing is right here. I have it here. You can kind of see with the amount of the sand as I scroll down, but it's just so subtle and hard to notice. So I think it's because it might be doing a parallax with the entire section versus just the image in the background. I don't know, but I think unfortunately right now it is a miss. So I'm going to go here, I'm going to back up, and let's go ahead and try it with that paid add-on Elementor extras. So let me go back to my dashboard here and let's go ahead and disable it and then enable that other plugin. So here's my list of plugins. I'm testing a bunch of things with this website right now. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and activate Elementor extras right here. And it might prompt me to pop in a license code or something like that. And then I'm going to go back into the granular controls. It's a great plugin, but maybe just not for Parallax right now. Okay, so I'm going to disable the Parallax feature, click on Save Changes. So now let's go ahead and jump in that same page and see what we can do with the Elementor extras. So I'm going to go to Elementor, my library, and then let's go ahead and go back in that same page like this. And let's see what we have going on. And let's see if we can have a more noticeable parallax effect. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click right here. Oops, right here, and get into my section settings. And then I'm going to go into style. And let's see where it does. Okay, so now we have the parallax background, but you can see this is from Elementor Extras. So let's turn it on. And you can already see a difference. You can already see the text scrolling above the image like that. It's just much better. And we also get options for parallax. So we can control the speed and we can also control the direction. So if I wanted the parallax direction to move to the right, I could do that. So now you see how when I scroll, it kind of moves a little bit. I think I'd actually like that more if it was left. Let's see, there it is. So when you scroll, you get that option, which is really nice. And you'd expect that from a paid plugin. Let's see what the speed increase does. Yeah, you see that it moves jarringly fast. So I don't need to continue experimenting with this plugin. You can see when it comes to parallax, right now we're getting the best results out of Elementor extras right here. But I think there's a lot of potential still with granular controls for the developer to tweak it and make it more effective, or maybe give you an option if he wants to do that. But if you just want a free way that guaranteed to work right now, go ahead and click on this article for Sniffle Valve and just follow this easy tutorial of just copying and pasting a little bit of code on over, and the full tutorials are right here. So anyways, what do you think of Parallax? Personally, it's funny, I just made this video. I'm not a fan of Parallax. I don't feel like it's something that I have to have on my website. But what I've noticed is a lot of people are passionate about having this effect and they really want that motion on their website. And I totally get it. We all have different tastes and preferences. But I want to hear what you think about Parallax and the Parallax effect down below in the comments section. And if you've used any of these methods to add Parallax to Elementor successfully, go ahead and share your experiences down below. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.